This video provides an overview of the App Engine Studio. We'll demonstrate how to build an app from a template and from scratch. You can skip to these topics from the YouTube description for this video. App Engine Studio is a guided, low-code tool for developing ServiceNow applications. Administrators can delegate development work to developers of any skill level so your organization can scale application development quickly and safely. You can use our templates library with many business use cases to quickly build fully functional apps. And when you're building out your app, you can use our powerful tools to add data, experiences, automation, and security. These tools include UI Builder to edit portals and workspaces, Catalog Builder to create service catalog items, Mobile App Builder to build mobile experiences, Flow Designer to automate application processes, and Table Builder to edit data models in a table format. Now let's check out the interface and see how to get help while building an app. We access My Apps, Available App Templates, and Helpful Resources from the top navigation bar. We select the Help icon to access the Help Center. Notice how the contents change depending on where we navigate to in App Engine Studio. Here are the quick start options for adding components to your apps, browsing templates, or accessing resources and tutorials to learn more. Now let's look at how to build an app. We'll start with the easiest way, which is to use a template. In our example, we want to build an app for employees to submit time off requests. This time off template looks like just what we need. We can be sure by reviewing the app template information page to see previews of the app, the app description and other ways to use it, and what it contains. Let's go ahead and use this template to build the app. We enter a name and description, and we can upload an optional app logo. When the app is ready, we can review it on the app dashboard. The application is broken down by its components. We can preview some of them. Here's the table this template produces. We can also review components by type. Let's preview this portal and then edit it in the UI Builder. After we've made any changes to the app, we submit it for IT review. The status changes to in review. Our administrator will test it, then we'll be notified by email when the app is approved and published or rejected. Now let's look at how to build an app from scratch. For this example, we have a unique use case. Our company made a substantial investment in artwork years ago, but employees are asking for new artwork to refresh their spaces. Rather than buy new artwork, our CEO wants to leverage the existing inventory by allowing each location to request and loan artwork to other locations via an app. We reviewed the templates, but we can't find one that addresses this use case. So let's create a new app. We start by creating the new app, and the app dashboard appears. The page guides us to complete the first step, adding data to the app. We can upload a spreadsheet, use an existing table, or create a new table from scratch. Let's create a new table. Here's our new table. We can edit, delete, or preview it, or add a new table here. The app dashboard advances to the next step, creating experiences for our app. The collapsible guidance panel displays which step we're on in the process and allows us to navigate to other steps. We We have several interfaces to choose from. Let's create the main interface for this app, the portal for managing artwork available for loan. And here we can preview the portal we just created. You'll need to edit the portal to meet your app requirements. We also need a catalog item so users can request artwork, so let's add that experience as well. Next up, we're ready to add automation to our app. We can build a workflow from scratch or use one of the predefined workflows. We need an approval for our catalog item, so we select that one. We select the template catalog item we just created and enter the price to trigger a required approval. The last step is adding security to our app. We can build a new role or use an existing one. Then we specify permissions for the role. In our example, this role will have all permissions. We also need to specify which experiences the role applies to. Finally, after we've edited and reviewed all of our app's components, we submit it for IT review. The status changes to in review. Our administrator will test it, then we'll be notified by email when the app is approved and published or rejected. And with only a few steps, we quickly created a powerful application for our offices while saving IT valuable time and resources. For more information, see our product documentation, knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.